So you know who 6ix9ine is, the rainbow colored, rainbow haired, rainbow grilled, young Latino man who kind of looks like a leprechaun who struck a pot of gold with his overall trolling. He participated in the molestation of a young girl in which he took a plea deal for. He actually assaulted a young teenager, which he took a plea deal for. And also, he kind of did his whole thing with Treyway Gang, which, you know, I believe he's going to take a plea for. So, you know, he's kind of like a notorious kind of kid right now. And now he dropped his album, which was freer for him, which was had more freedom than him when dropped, you know, on all the streaming platforms. And now here it is. So let's start with the basics. Now you have a song like Stupid, which, you know, have references to like Nick Cannon, in which I think it was a slight diss to, you know, Ludacris, since he did that whole skit with Nick Cannon. He also dissed, you know, Chief Keef with the whole referencing to Fredo. And he also samples 50 Cent, which is kind of like a friend of his nowadays. So, yeah, that started it out. And also, there was a diss on Ebro, and even Kanye dissed Ebro on Conga, in which he was featured or whatever, you know. So, yeah, they also dissed Sway Lee, Sway in the Morning, I mean, on the song Conga, which was kind of shocking, but hey, how, Sway, how? And then you have Nicki dropping her part on Fifi, in which she dropped the whole AC thing. And this is not the only time Nicki dropped a very bizarre verse on an AC. If you listen to Super Boom, which, you know, she mentioned the top down and having the air conditioning on, which wastes a lot of money. But overall, she blows 6ix9ine on Fifi. So, yeah. Now, the song TikTok, it kind of reminds me of Maroon 5 with that castrated little guitar, beta guitar on it. But I do like the flow on here, and it is the best TikTok of our generation since Kesha. And Lil Baby says he needs to stop drinking lean or whatever, so that's nice. You know, of the two Young Thug twins, he does have the best flow. Now, on the song Tigga, or whatever, the one that features Lanes, Lanes drop is a verse about, like, Bruce Lee, and he repeats that shit until it gets annoying. Also, they did a funny little Treyway skit that was pretty funny, where he pretty much says things with T. He mentions Trojan because he's on Drake's dick. Also, the song ZZ, the beat sounds similar to, like, ZZ, like the Kodak track that, you know, Kodak did. It might be a reference to Jordan or Lucas, but I don't know, man. Also, 6ix9ine says he's not fucking with the old crew that he used to run with, Treyway, so that's something. Mama has, you know, Kanye West referencing how he got his girlfriend tits, and then 6ix9ine reference how he got the Kylie Jenner lips for his girl, which was pretty nice. And, you know, Nicki Minaj does this excellent line where she says that she has a hating bitch throwing dirt on her, but it turns out that it turned into her funeral. I thought that that was nice. Boogie with the hoodie shows he has way more balls than, of course, Lanes when he says that all his hits are R&B. At least he admits that. And then you have the two Spanish tracks, which I like that he's embracing his Mexican heritage. He did that a little bit with the whole track with Kanye, where he says that they don't like him because he's Mexican. So that was pretty nice. Speaking of Kanye, Kanye says that people think he's as black as Macklemore since he joined up with Donald Trump. And also 6ix9ine shows how he's very lazy, which he recycles lines from Nelly, when it comes to drop down, get your eagle on, he recycles yet again 50. He recycles a verse that he spit for Reloaded by that European DJ, I forgot, that goes like with the flute. Yeah, I noticed that. Also, he recycles a verse from A$AP Rocky, showing why he's one of the laziest rappers in the world. Leading to the next track is one of the reasons why he says he's hope his fans remember him. Probably not, since he's going to jail for like maybe a long time. And then we get to Hold Up, Let Me Get It Started, BB with the Robins, Looking All Retarded. Now that track right there is booming, flaming with just flames and stuff like that. That's a nice track right there, especially if he mentions Dummy Boy and Stupid. I like how he ties that in with the whole album. But yeah, when I saw that whole song on here, I was flames. Windu, or whatever, however fuck you pronounce it, shows that 6ix9ine is nothing without a feature, because it's just so boring. 6ix9ine is the equivalent of Cap G on this track, to tell you the truth. And then we end it off with Dummy, which I don't know, Trig or Trey or whatever fuck his name is, Draw. He takes up most of the track, which kind of makes it boring, and 6ix9ine ends his album abruptly with nothing amazing to say about it. Overall, he's one of the laziest rappers out here, and I'm giving his album a 4. Please like, subscribe, share this video. I'm out, man.